Dividend stock is one of the best decisions for investors who are planning to invest in some stocks because it pays you money every quarter and every year, and as long as company going very well. But here is the one question: what is good dividend stock? So in this video we'll talking about this and talking about stock, talking about dividend, and I will also mention a few risks which you have to consider before you invest in stocks dividend. Just before we start, I want to thank you a lot for your support, for being part of your community. If you are not part of this community, I encourage you to subscribe to this channel and also to smash the like button before we start. So in this video we will talking about five stocks dividend, and we will also talking about three risks which you have considered, and this risk will not be neglected if you are plan to invest in some dividend stocks. So let's talk for the beginning in about the risks. So first risk is payout ratio. Payout ratio, the percentage of profit paid out by a company to cover the dividend risk, is that too high? Payout limits future growth. So this is very simple. The bigger our percentage, the stock has more value. So payout ratio is different for some sectors. Some sectors higher payout ratio than the other sector. Second risk is invest in the company. Invest in the company, not dividend. Make sure the company is a solid investment, not just because it offers an attractive dividend. This is very good question for dividend. If some company offer a very, very attractive dividend, it does not mean that this company will have that this company have very good business model. So it does not mean that this is good company, because some company offer attractive dividend just to attract some investors to collect some money for their benefits. In this situation, you have to be very, very careful and prepare yourself if you plan to invest in some company that offers very, very high dividend yield. And the third risk is risk to dividends investors. Watch out for the high yield myth. So you have to always look at what price stocks done in the last few years. So you have to look at the chart, and if you notice that some stocks drop about 50% over the last few years, it is usually some wrong here. So it can be some very, very bad decision this company in the last few years, and it can be some very bad business model in this company. So in this situation, usually company could love dividend yield, or even the cut out all of his dividend. So this is it for three risks of investing in dividend stocks, and we are going to the five stocks in which we will discuss five dividend stocks and talking about the fundamental of stocks and the prospects to grow. So we will make sure that each company has produced positive return in the last few years and have the very good potential for future growth. So the first company is Crestwood Equity Partners. So first high yield stocks is Crestwood Equity. So this is a first high yield stocks, ticker is CAQP. So this is Energy Master Limited Partnership, which pay 6.5% dividend yield. Crestwood is very good example of why you have to look at the return and at the dividend yield, because this company has made over 30% growth in last 3 years. Maybe in our list this is the lowest dividend of our five stocks, but it has annual growth of over 30% in last few years. Crestwood is a traditional midstream MLP, which means that owns oil and gas pipeline processing station, and then those storage facility, and then charge energy explorers fee to transport through the pipelines in stores in its tankers. The company has long-term contract with some of the biggest company, including ExxonMobil, Shell, Royal Dutch, and others. From this revise, we can see that Crestwood covered dividend by 150%. It usually mean that cash flow is very, very good, that cash flow is here, and it mean that maybe this company will increase this its dividend yield in the future. So our second stocks is Chimera Investment Corporation. This is the mortgage real estate investment trust. Chimera Investment ticker is IIM. This mortgage trust has a very, very solid dividend yield by 10.43%. This is one of the oldest mortgage trusts. So what I like from this company is that this trust survived the mortgage market crash and stock market crash in 2007. So also I have to mention that this company is very diversified, so it means that in this, if you invest in this company, you maybe will have a little bit less risk. So one problem with this company is the real estate crash. If real estate market crash, this company always or this company usually go down a lot. So if you are planning to invest in such company, make sure to prepare yourself, make sure to do the homework and do some study before you invest your hard-earned money. The third stocks is Alliance Bernstein Holding. Third High Yield is one of the few stocks outside MLP rates and business development companies. It is Alliance Bernstein Holdings. This company say that has over the $500 million in asset under its management, and this company has a strong 6.6% dividend yield. There are very good diversification in this company. So if you look at the photo, you can see that this company is very well diversified by investment services, geographic investment services, and the client domicile. So this company in the past has not had very good consistent payout, but they invest a lot of in their business model. They plan to increase dividend yield and plan to make dividend very, very consistent in the future. So four stocks on our list is New York Mortgage Trust. And this is another high dividend stocks with dividend yield in 12.7%. So this is very similar with Chimera Investment. This is a company which invests in different types of mortgages. This company is focused a little more on multi-home properties. So this is stocks is a bit risky, but also has a very, very high dividend yield. There is very, very similarity between Chimera and the New York Mortgage Trust. And if you have both of them of your portfolio, you are very well diversified, and then you are less in risks. So our last stocks in our list is Sonoco. Sonoco have a different model compared to last two mortgage trust. Sonoco has a dividend yield of 10.68% dividend yield. So this company is specialized in mainstream companies like pipelines and energy storage. Sonoco also operating in retail and wholesale station. So this is very good company with a very, very good business model. It deserves to be considered for someone's portfolio. So that was our five high dividend yield stocks. And for the end, I have to mention that if you are planning to invest in every stocks, you have to prepare yourself, you have to study the company, study the financial of the company, and do the homework before you invest your hard-earned money. You have to look deep in your potential stocks and make sure that some very, very important thing is not missing before you invest. So that was our five high dividend yield stocks. Let me know in the comment section what is your opinion about these stocks and what you're thinking about this dividend. Also, if you like this video, smash the like button, and if you don't like, also smash the like button, and do not forget to subscribe to this channel, because it can help you and it is very much free. And as always, I'm thanking you for watching, and have a good rest of the day.